opportunity and he let it slip from his grasp, and in came James McCarthy, and Dublin can break once again with Alan Brogan picking up his first possession all the way down to his younger brother Bernard. Back to Alan again, two former footballers of the year, the Brogans. Has options right and left, needs to make his mind up, and his mind was made up to kick it with his left and to boot it over the bar. What an introduction. The hill erupts, sea of blue and navy there, ready to salute a point by Alan Brogan to see Dublin four ahead.
Lately, did you ever feel a pain? Hollywood's rich Dublin footballers. Will you welcome all-star centre forward Alan Brogan?
From all corners, the match still being played. Rory Stafford of Wexford. Stafford has a 45 and he takes the sensible and makes the sensible decision. The only option open to him, a pitch invasion here. Four in a row. The last time they did that in 1995, they went on to win St Maguire. And if you think he's seen,
I'm not a soldier.
right call.
Sometimes I feel like my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you.
And Michael Murphy came out.
Sometimes I feel like the opening possession there. I just don't care. You've got the law. I need to see me through. Sometimes it seems the law is just too rough. Anything's wrong, no matter what I do. Now and then it seems like the life is just too much. You've got the law.
Well, I'm actually here in the Brogan household. We're talking here to Maria and Jamie. Maria, why aren't you in the club here tonight?
Well, my job before every championship game is to take care of himself so Alan gets a good night's sleep. So
Ollie, that's all from the Brogan household. I'll leave you with a few words for the most important man, Jamie.
Up there.
Oh, that'll be a video clip in a few years' time. You're like your father.
Up the dubs.
And yay. Dubs for Sam.
Dubs Sam.
82,000 people up front. The name about whom there was a doubt, of course, is Alan Brogan. Diarmaid Colony, who got that reprieve from a would-be suspension. And finally, Bernard Brogan. Tasty duel once again. Alan Brogan coming in here. Killian Young alongside him. Gets the shot in. The crowd will tell you where it's gone. It's gone over the bar. Alan Brogan getting Dublin's first today. But a lovely, well-constructed move there involving Bernard Brogan. Finished off by Alan. And it's Dublin 1. Kerry 1 there too as Danica Walsh. Coming away as Anthony Marr. Slipped as far as Aidan O'Mahony. And eventually lost by Killian Young, lost to Alan Brogan, who kicks and scores another. Two in a row for Alan Brogan, and Dublin take the lead by 2-1, and we're in the 15th minute.
Yeah, Kerry might be the green somewhat, and Killian Young coming off with the ball, that hasn't scored, but I think referee was correct on anything.
Yeah, right now it's going nicely for them, but a goal for Dublin would unsettle all of that. Free kick from Keane O'Sullivan. After 7 minutes to go, Alan Brogan sends it. McMenamin dodging, McMenamin scoring! There's a point between the teams, and Kevin McMenamin has kicked a beauty and sent Dublin fans into raptures. 64 minutes on the clock. Beautiful pass, wonderful work, precision here by McMenamin. He made a difference in the semi-final, and when he took the pass from Brogan here, he's made a difference in the final itself, rounding Declan O'Sullivan and beating Brendan Keeley 110-19. It ain't for you, Daniel Mohan. To Donaghy, high up into the clouds.
Gooch is in there. Doesn't need the Gooch, it's gone over. It's a remarkable point by Kieran Donaghy. He's kicked his second, he's kicked the team's level.
So never mind the scoring. There goes to him.
If there's a replay, it'll be in 2 weeks' time, we believe. It's 111 to 111. Oh, Jared Brennan was given a free kick and he's now knocked Donaghy out of the way. And the free kick is going to be cancelled. And that kind of silliness will annoy Pat Gilroy and the management team, and correctly so. 15 seconds nearly into stoppage time, at the beginning of 2 minutes of it, the game's there to be won. Back come Dublin again, Alan Brogan, Pat Menaman. Is there a winner? Who's going to get it? Will it be today? McCauley, Conor Sparrow's Connolly, stopped in his tracks by Aidan O'Mahony. Still Dermot Connolly. Kerry back defending, Mac Menaman attacking, and he's tripped, and it's a free in. A free kick to win the All-Ireland 95. What drama in Croke Park.
Well, it was extraordinary, and I've seen said before, and I took and talked about Stephen Cluxton, talked about his importance to the Dublin team, and talked about his ability to accurately kick frees from distance. Now he has the most important kick of his career for Dublin, for their supporters. Let's see, can he hold his nerve?
Stephen Cluxton, the fans trying to hold their nerves in his 55th championship match. 15 points in his career so far. He's already got one today. The distance with the angle, about 45 metres. Here he comes to win the All-Ireland. Cluxton, he's put it over the bar! And Dublin are in front by 112 to 111. Cluxton, the hero, and the 2 minutes of added time has been played. And we now wait for the referee's whistle. Referee looks at his watch. Kerry, it's all over. Dublin have won the All-Ireland. The most dramatic, the most wonderful of finishes. Kerry beaten. Dublin, true triumph. What a triumph. It's Stephen Cluxton who's done it. As Dublin end a long, barren spell of some 16 years. And a first win in the final since 1995.
I watch you look at me, watch my people grow, and I know just where I am. How many times do I have to learn? All the love I have is in my mind, but I'm a lucky man.
Christy Cody hands over Sam Maguire. It's going to Dublin, it's going to Brian Cullen, because Dublin are the All-Ireland champions for the 23rd time. They are the top team, the best team in Ireland in 2011.
I'm smiling, I feel no disgrace.
And how much this is going to mean to Dublin fans all over the capital. It's a huge boost for football.
Coming and going. I watch you look at me, watch my feet are growing. I know just who I am.
Oh, young lads from Potter's Ford. We have an opportunity. We have some fantastic role models here. These guys should be to the forefront of the campaign to promote Gaelic football. That's what we're looking for tomorrow.
I hope you understand. I hope you understand. Oh.
Centre half forward. It's a dollar for Plunkett's club in Dublin. It's Alan Brogan.
13 points this year. Man of the match in three of Dublin's six games. Alan demonstrated all his old flair and vision. A vital cog in Pat Gilroy's winning combination. Alan Brogan, centre forward.
Nominees for Footballer of the Year are Alan Brogan, Dublin. Darren O'Sullivan, Kerry. Stephen Cluxton, Dublin. Desiree Happy. GA GPA Footballer of the Year is Alan Brogan.
And what a couple of years for the Brogan brothers. They emulate the feat of the Kerry O'Shea's from All the Mohair. 2011 Footballer of the Year, Alan Brogan.
Attack, and Paul Flynn is there to try and act as a conduit between defence and attack.
I believe we can keep the promise of our founding.
Makes an angle for himself.
If you're willing to work hard,
going to be close.
It doesn't matter who you are.
It clips the post.
Or where you come from. Or what you look like.
Our line stays like this.
Or where you
love. The defending league champions will have a job of work to do.
To qualify
for the semi-finals again. Can they conjure up one last trick? Brogan. O'Gara. Oh, he's done it!
Brogan. The brother was calling for it, but Alan is going up. We've seen him do this so many times. Brilliant play. Making a statement in his own way. The Dublin man from Kilmacud Crooks. And it's Alan Brogan again. Looking sharp. Ball inside for Brian Fenton. Alan Brogan is there. This could be point number two. Very impressive. Alan Brogan. Oh, superb. Absolutely.
Bernard Brogan. Awkward angle, so he turns it back wisely. And his brother Alan puts his boot through it. And listen to the cheer.
Brilliantly
done by the Mexican
skies.
Presenting to the Laney Cup, to Stephen Cook, Dublin with a match for tonight. He was able to step it over the bar. That 5-point gap is restored. Are you with me? Yes, by the way, the Mexican skies. Bring some margaritas back. Listen to the Mariners play at midnight. Keep taking the bet.
Are you with me?
Alan Brogan. Oh, that is so strong. He's gonna. Kennelly goes long. Four big male men lined up across the middle of Croke Park, and Michael Darren McCauley has it.
Are you with me?
Paddy Andrews. And now Alan Brogan. 3 points between them, they could be in for a goal. Down into the back of the net for a goal of Brogan. Going off.
at the end of our wonderful career, replacing a young man at the beginning of his. So he throws the ball up at the end. The referee, Donahue, has it. Here's a chance. Oh, Killian Young have the opportunity, and he let it slip from his grasp. And in came James McCarthy, and Dublin can take once again with Alan Brogan, picking up his first possession, all the way down to his younger brother Bernard. Back to Alan again. Two former footballers of the year, the Brogans. Has options right and left. Needs to make his mind up.
Deserves all the plaudits.
Claxton back out here as far as McManaman, but it's all over. Dublin have won the All-Ireland for 2015. GAA President Diagol O'Farrell presents Sam to Stephen, and the Dublin captain lifts the lock as the Dubs are grand champions for the 25th time. Champions for 2015. Party time in the capital. The candidate for Footballer of the Year. There's one who has already been Footballer of the Year. Came on today and within seconds got a point. And then Darren Daly.
Are you with me?
Look, I am joined here on the podium at the moment by the Brogan family, and I was talking to Alberto Senior about the number of All-Ireland medals that are in the house, and the count is 10, I gather.
As of today, it's 10. Two more added today. Before today, we had 8 and 10 today, so it's a fantastic achievement.
Yeah. You must be very proud of the family, and particularly the two lads on the panel at the moment.
Oh, yeah, no, we live in the present. I was delighted for them. I'm always apprehensive about the football matches, but I'm really thrilled that they actually pulled it off today.
By the way, Alan, who is the other half of the household cheering for today?
I think she's a dub at this stage now. Probably in the early years, it was a bit touch and go, but then certainly at this stage, she's cheering for the Dubs.
Yeah,
I'm sure they won't begrudge her that.
She saw the sign of the wall, yeah.
What about Alan Brogan, ladies and gentlemen? Andy Cole's bang over.
We'll see, we enjoy this one for now. For a long time, when I was playing for Dublin, there was no All-Irelands coming back. So to have 3 in 5 years is fantastic. And as Finner said, thanks so much for the support. It's fantastic to bring Sam Maguire back to O'Connell Street tonight. Thank you.
Sam has come home back to Moneyball.